Hello, welcome. Well, welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews, but Whiskey Watch. Not Cider Spectacles or anything like that. Whiskey Watch, as is my wont, I drink all sorts of things. I eat all sorts of things. I believe in being a bit of a bon viveur. A lover of the good life, and I think everyone can live to a certain extent a good life. Certainly in beer you can, and to a certain extent in whiskey you can as well. You can really experience some grand and lovely flavors for not a lot of money, especially if someone buys you things for Christmas and birthdays and things like that. Well, Mrs. has bought me one of these. Oh my word! It's a green bottle, Tobermory, 1798. Established on the Isle of Mull. Mulligan tyre. I ain't Mulligan tyre. Not Mulligan's tyres. So that's that. It's a lovely green bottle. Now, they used to use different colour of bottles to hide all sorts of den of iniquities. I think they called them black bottles, even though there was greens and browns and all sorts of things. But I think they called them black bottles. And some were black, whatever colour they was, if they was coloured bottles, I think, unless I'm much mistaken. Leave it in your comments because I'll read it out in a minute when I check up on the comments. I'm pulling the whole lot of that off because I don't like all these bits of crap left on the bloody thing. Foil's nice, I don't mind it, but I suppose I suppose it's safeguard to keep some of these foil things. So if you twist them and pull them, twist them and pull them, twist them and pull them, you can get them all the way off, and then you can put them all back down again and squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Take it back in the shop with your own urine sample and go, I won the one he wanted, mate. Next thing you know, I'm pouring out a urine sample. There you go. There's got to be kind of, different ways of sealing things. Right. Interesting little point. When you get your cork, don't shake all the gear up into it. Get it cold, because if it's any touched it, what will stay behind is the oils. Smells quite nice. It actually smells delicious. Right, let's pour it in a little whiskey glass. Now you want to try and get it to just below where the little bulbous size is, where the widest point in that glass is. The rest of it is the flame. You want it just below because that's about right. You want it just below because you want a tiny bit of room to pour your well, not pour, to just tip a. Where'd I put a bleeding cork? There it is. I'm sorry, I'm completely doolally tat. I'm wobbling you now because I'm putting it on top of the computer, the laptop, that I'm sitting there chatting to you in the little light on the thing, you know. Very weird bottle, very nice, kind of very old shape, oldie style. These sort of bottles, I don't know if that is if they've kept the same bottles they used to have, but this is very reminiscent of bottles you find. Sometimes you find bits and pieces. If you're very lucky, you find a whole bottle. My mate Stephen B kind of goes down the beaches and all that business and goes hunting for bits and bobs and pottery and stuff and finds all sorts of bits and bobs. I kind of told him about one of the what one of the thingies was, one of the poems on one of his bits of pottery that he had, anyway, I do digress, but very reminiscent of that, little bottles and things, little medicine bottles and what have you. Yeah. And it looks really similar to the oldie type of bottle. Now, I'm going to have a little snifter and a whifter of this. What sort of these we're on about? It should say on the side here, 46.3, so just I don't think we're going to be calling for much. If you stick a bugle in, you're going to be getting not a lot, you're going to be getting burned. But if you get out here, you're picking up lemon notes, you're picking up from out here, you're picking up almost little coconut notes, little toasted coconut out there. That is really interesting, really strange. God, that is weird. You're picking up tiny little bits of fennels for kind of like the little hints, little tiny hints of a peat sort of note in there, but you're not getting nothing big, you know, it's nothing big in there, it's just almost as if someone's just gone blip, 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 just like put a couple of blips of an ILA whiskey in there, say. Just getting little tiny little hints of that. It's making my mouth water. Right. Very light and bouncy. It's not, you know, big and bolstrous and caramel and all that business. I mean, I just had the what do you call it here? The red label. It was like caramel. It was just a pitch invasion of caramel. It wasn't, it's nothing refined and subtle about it. But it was nice enough. You know, it was nice enough. And I reckon it'd go nice in a porridge, a little spicy edge to it. But anyway, we're talking about this one. This one is very, very different. It's got very kind of complex notes in there. See, this you can talk about. You know, that was, I found very hard reviewing that because it's just blah, and that's it, you know. But you're getting little floral notes, you're getting little almost piney, sort of minty almost. Kind of like a Christmas tree pine sort of notes in there. Squirrel shit. Sorry. But you're getting kind of something nutty in there as well. That ain't squirrel shit, it ain't. Something earthy. Something very earthy. But as I say, not a peaty earth. Something earthy, like when you're digging up spuds, potatoes. You know, when you're digging up potatoes and things, not a lot of you would know about that, but when you've been gardening, everyone's done gardening when you're a kid, surely, and you got all that smell on your hands, you get a little bit of that. But when you're digging up potatoes, the soil has changed. The potatoes changed the soil. And it's kind of slightly different. There's different minerals in there. It's got a different note to it. It's got that in there. Little orangey notes, little backgrounds of orangey notes. You've got little tangerine notes. You've got little them little fistlets with the little leaves. Crispy little edge leaves that curl around it. You must try these things. You really must. Some of them are fantastic. But little tea notes, little bergamot orange notes. That's really nice. It really is nice. Blob water. Let's try it without. Cool. About a teaspoon or just a tad more than a teaspoon, I can personally. Now look, even though I blobbed that in, didn't carefully do it down the sides, you can see that that is not, I'm sure that it's non-chill filtered, because you start to get a separation of the oils. Even though I've blobbed it in, look, see the different colours? See that, look. See the pale bottom and see the deeper top. Can you see that? Can you see it? Even on this snotty, dodgy old kind of internet camera thing on the computer, little pinhole camera and all that, you know, you can still see that separation, even though there's not a a white background or something like that, you know, you can still see that separation out there. I'm pretty sure we're talking non-chill filtered. That's the thing. We've got the box here. When you're getting to the chill filtering and that, and it don't look like it's got E150C in there either. Colour, bright lemony gold, see? Yeah, 10 years old. 10 years old, that's what it should look like, wasn't it? White, something white background. Well, it's not really white, but it's a Tesco's receipt. It's kind of, really light. If you're getting like a 3 year old, or, you know, maybe a blend of different ages, and it's like brown, you know, it's kind of coloured up with the same stuff they put in Coca-Cola, they put in kind of Worcester sauce and soy sauce and everything else. Oh, no, not Worcester sauce, they don't put it in there because that's done with all sorts of aging of fish and stuff like that. it sounds horrible, doesn't it? But I, but all crap, all stuff like, and it's, I don't think whiskey of any age should have colouring in it. If you get a minimum age of whiskey is 3 years old. If you get a 3 year old whiskey that ain't leached those colours out of the oak vats and things, oak casks and everything else, then let's just have a check of the comments. Nothing. I love it. Love it when I don't get a comment at all. See, on a bit, it's very kind of unnerving for me. Hey! How much is that bolt? I have no idea, mate. I better put that one up. Ouch! Dodgy shoulder. Better put that one up there. But, and the case as well. I have no idea. The missy's got it. I'm sure you can find out on the internet. But, it's, you know, it says on there, unchill filtered. Ah, ha, ha. Right on the front, unchill filtered. Yeah, I'm right. Yeah, you get those oils kind of distilled there. Chill filtered, and they come out like butter floating on. You know, like if you make a good stock or gravy or something like that, you put it in the fridge, and all that you. The top, you've got all the oil on the top, the fat and lard and stuff like that. Well, that's carrying all the flavours, and same with that. You know, I've just mixed it in there, but it's carrying the flavours in it, and you lose all that. You know, you lose so many of them by chill filtering it. Those rich island character with tantalising hints of grass malt, gingerbread. Gingerbread? Gingerbread? Yeah, grass, malt, stewed fruit syrup. Stewed fruit, I'm getting. Polished oak. I'm not getting polished oak. I'm getting oak and I'm getting vanilla. And gingerbread. No, I'm not really getting the ginger on that, so not on the nose. Palette, I'm not looking at the palette, because I hate preconceived taste notes. For those fortunate enough to uncover it, here lies a rare jewel of whiskey. It is a rare jewel, because it's very, very, very different to anything else you've got. It really is. It's a very rare jewel. And it is magical Isle of Moles only distillery. Pardon me. It has a gentle sweetness on the nose and that's taste notes again. I'm not reading it. Right. Let's down a bit. Let's sniff it with the water. Getting lemony edges this time. Kind of like homemade lemonade in there. Getting honey, getting kind of those slight nutty background notes. So you have to get in a bit closer with the water in there, even though there's not a lot in there. Do you know what? Funny enough, with the water in, again, it kind of robs a little, it sort of makes it a bit more flamey and less subtle, if anything. Two recent posts, we'll see. So I'll look nice first. Hey, Lee! Russell, having yourself a tasty marathon tonight. I see. Cheers, Terry. Lee White likes a nice whiskey as well. He's a very, very knowledgeable chap when it comes to beer and everything else. And also when it comes to whiskey. Go and have a look at his reviews. Check him out. He's doing, I believe he's, whether he's doing them now, he's kind of slipping one in now and again. But he was talking about doing a few more whiskey reviews, and I think he should. Because I've done a collab review with him, and he knows what he's talking about. And it's really nice to see someone that admires good whiskey and takes it on board, especially someone outside of the, you know, United Kingdom, Great Britain, or whatever you want to call it. You know, someone outside, someone from the other side of the pond, you know, he's Canadian, by the way. Someone on the other side of the pond that appreciates our, you know, one of our kind of works of art. I say our, you know, it's like when Andy Murray won the tennis, you know. He's our boy. Hey, he's our boy. Yeah, I'm British when it comes to that. You know, he's a Brit, you know. Okay, the new and all that. Yeah, sorry. And there you are, says Mickey Lopez. Yeah, I was doing a beer review before this, and it all went tits up, and everything went. So I thought, you know what? I only had a little bit left in the bottle, and I thought, is it worth starting it up again just to say bye and hello, bye and all that? So I'll say me bye byes on the comments later on, you know. But there you go. Sorry, guys. And that, you know. Mr. Green Man YTC says, "Oh yeah, and thanks for making my porridge more interesting in the mornings. Yeah, it will be, mate. I tell you. I've been drinking whiskey for a few months, and I never thought to adding to it for." The last few weeks, my porridge tastes like heaven. Oh, cool. I'm glad, you know, you've already tried it with it. It is something else. And, you know, for me now, I mean, since I've had diabetes, I had to, you know, well, I've got rid of it now. I have, you know, I'm medical, and all the medical people I've spoke to say, you can't get rid of diabetes, you're stuck with it for life. I've got rid of mine. I've got rid of it. Don't ask me how, because I'm a, you know, a kind of maybe I'm a kind of science wonder or something. I've escaped death I don't know how many times. The Grim Reapers give up bloody calling for me now. You wouldn't believe how many times I've escaped death. And you know, I get injured and things like that, and I'm bouncing back. They say that there, you know, I had certain accidents and things. They go, you're not going to be out of hospital within about 6 months. You know, you've done all your ribs and you've done brain damage and everything else. Yeah, well, okay, 6 days later, I'm like wobbling out of hospital because they won't feed me. Yeah, you know, so, okay, bye. Bye, everyone. Thanks very much. Thank you. Bye. In that absolute agony, but gritting my teeth like, I've got no morphine. All right, anyway. I do digress. Cool, it's really nice, really kind of floral and lovely. Tobermory, our things in Tobermory. I'm gonna taste it. Oh. Oh, bloody lovely. If you tried a lot of kind of, if you drink a lot of different single malts and things and try to, you know, not and as I say, not just the single malts, but serious whiskies and that, if you've tried different whiskies that are outside of the mass produced stuff, you really, really will appreciate this, because it is very, 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 very different. You know, you get certain ones that are, you know, very peaty, you get other ones that are malty, you get, and they're all, every whiskey that you get is different. Even the mass produced ones are different. But you get certain times when you think, oh wow, this is wonderful, it really is. Let's see what someone else has said here, where are we? Lee Russell says, cheers for the plug, ha ha ha. Now get back to reviewing. Yeah, sorry Lee, I know I do ramble on a bit, but I kind of get passionate about things, you know, and I think that is the most important thing. You know, you can get people that can get quite a lot of information and squeeze it into a few minutes in there, and it's like, and this is the so this and this and that's it. Okay, bye. All right, and you go, what? You know, but I think some certain things deserve to be sung about, and Lee's channel, I think, does deserve to be sung about, because he tells it how it is, which I think is important. He cusses and swears a bit now and again, which is cool, you know, I like that. I'm trying to keep my own down a little bit. I'm always biting my lip, because I often like the swear words, because I'm fighting to come out. But what I like is he will sing the praises of the great beers, and unlike, not mentioning any names or anything like that, but unlike some reviewers out there that seem to be in the pockets of not some reviewers, there's very few, but this, you know, there's some that are kind of egotistical, and they're in the pockets of brewers and that, and you get poxy brewers that are adding all sorts of sugar and stuff like that to beers and that, and the same goes for whiskies as well, right? But it's less obvious in whiskies, you know. Some whiskies mass produced and they're all right, you know. But when you get a manky crap beer, and you get someone go, this is lovely, I'm at a GB beer, or I'm at it, you know, and you go, oh. And it grinds on me, it really does. And it leaves us, I think Lee's the same, he's kind of out that same mold, where if he gets a Bud Light or something like that, he'll go, what is this? You know, or if he gets a Bombardier, you know, he'll go, what the bloody hell? And the same with anything, you know, you should, if someone is commercially selling it, they're dipping their hand in your pocket. So I believe that if they're dipping your hand in your pocket, you should be getting something for that pleasure. You know, you should be getting something for that. They're dipping your hand in your pocket and lying to you and saying this beer is going to be fantastic, or this scotch or whatever, this whiskey or, the, you know, anything is going to be fantastic, whatever they're selling you. And then you end up with a McDonald's meal and they've sold it to you as a Michelin star meal. It's not fantastic. You know, you've been robbed. And if someone is helping them to do that, you've been robbed double. And people hopefully trust what the reviewers, what us reviewers have got to say. Anyway, sorry, I've gone off the remit. Anyway, this was going to be a quick review. Sorry, guys. Well, let's have a taste. Mmm. Oh, it's lovely, isn't it? Isn't it lovely? That really is lovely. Right. Again, as I said, you're getting little bergamot sort of Earl Grey tea notes in there. You're getting little hints of pineapple as it warms up in your hand. You're getting little hints of pineapple come just creeping up on you. Really quiet, but just little bits of that. You're getting grapefruits, you're getting maybe something like a dried, you know, when you get these dried fruits, like a dried, this is funny, it's kind of hints of the powder you get out of a packet of dried banana. There's hints of that in there, just tiny hints of that, but you're getting the hints of also of dried strawberry as well. Little chunks of dried strawberry. If you get them in breakfast cereal, and you like me, you go, "Don't look. I don't. What? I nothing. I'm not doing anything. What? No, nothing." You're eating all the little red bits. Hey, why is this cereal? She comes in like, you know, why is this cereal got no red bits in it? I don't know. It's just how it turns up. I'll bet more. It's terrible. I'm telling you, it's terrible, sorry. Where are we? Right, no new comments, so goody good. Let's drink this down, guys and girls, I think. By the way, it's lovely, peppery notes as well. Let a whiskey make love to you. Let, you know, just let it warm in gradually. You don't go in there like, rah, boom, 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 like, you know, just getting a kiss first, you know, just a kiss on the lips, let it kind of just get into the saliva glands there, just let it wash there, let it get over the tip of the tongue, let it wash over the rest. Just get kind of cuddly with it, you know, don't go in there, boom, boom, it's like, you know, you ain't kind of trying to get it down and burn yourself. Just take your time. Acclimatise yourself to it as well, you know. Getting them coconut notes now as I'm getting it onto the back of the tongue. As I'm taking it straight across. And as I wash it all away. All the way around and breathing across it. I'm getting apple core, I'm getting some sort of roots of some sort. I can't actually say this. I may be able to say it in a way. Someone I knew once, long while ago, was growing something. Was growing, I can't remember what sort it was, but it was some sort of herb. I think it might have been related to hops or something like that, but sort of some sort of herb. And it grew quite a big plant, but it wasn't really any good for what he wanted it for. So I said, well, then they put little leaves in that, make little kind of little pictures and put them on velvet backgrounds and sell them for £5 each and whatever else, you know. And so he did that and got lots of money out of it, you know. Afterwards, there's little leaves like this and things like that and weren't much left of it. So I've got all the lot together, washed all the roots off and everything else and made a stew out of it. And it was delicious, one of the best stews I've ever made. There's a taste and a smell of stewed, I can't remember the name of that herb, but of stewed that particular herb. And I wished I could remember the name of it that it was growing at that time. So, yeah, see, I ain't got myself in trouble or nothing. Good, good. So, I can't remember what the bloody hell it was. But it's a long while ago. And there's hints of that. Hints, weird little hints of that in the taste and the smell. I'd be interested to know that when the distillers make the wash for the whiskies, if anyone has ever made a wash that has included hops in it, because that tastes slightly hoppy. That is delicious. Right, Tobermory, that's the box. I don't know how much it was because I got it as a present, but I've got to say, you must try it. Don't buy it and like it, I think. That one's lovely. Put the lid down. Little island there of Tobermory. There's a little, I don't know if you can see it. Pardon me. I'm just going to refresh the comments. But yeah, definitely try that if you can get hold of it. Unchill filtered, very important. Not coloured at all in any way. Distillers, if anyone's watching my inane dribble, which I very much doubt, but if anyone's watching it, distillers, please leave the E150C hemp. Yeah, it was something like that, hemp. It was related to hemp or marijuana. Not marijuana. Well, you said something wrong then. Hops or something like that. No, but I don't know. I think it's related to something like that. I really can't think what. yes, it was something like that. Legal, perfectly safe, legal, and everything else. Yeah, but and it was edible and it was delicious, nutritious, fantastic. Everyone else was like that. I'd gone in for about the eighth bowlful, I think I had. Like that. Lovely. Quick, newest first. Right, that's it. Everyone's gone. That's it. Right, well, chaps and girls and boys, I was quite surprised to see a few faces in. Not, as I say, I'm not... kind of advertised this up or anything. I just thought, you know what, I've got a bit of spare time, just throw a few live ones in, and thoroughly enjoyed having a little drop of scotch with you, a little whiskey with you, I should say. You know what I've got next? I've got tequilas. Tequila. Do you know what, I tasted one. And they're disgusting. Right, before I do go, how am I supposed to drink tequila? Because I tasted it raw and it was like, what a bloody hell is this? It was awful. Made out of some sort of plant that you chop all that business. But, right, tell us about it, guys. How are you supposed to drink it? I ain't drinking it with Coca-Cola and crap like that. It's either water or something, you know, fairly neutral. Otherwise, I don't think it's worth bleeding drinking it. But it's not worth drinking it raw. God, blimey. I'll try it again. You never know. I might have changed my opinion. Alright, so I'll see you in a minute. In it. Bye.